I'm Jeppe Hogeveen and I work at the Land and Water Division of FVO at its headquarters in Rome. I've been asked to give a quick introduction to the VAPOR project. Within FVO, we deal a lot with the question on how to achieve food security in the future while using natural resources in a sustainable manner. Agriculture is a very big water user, responsible for 70% of global water withdrawals. Therefore, a careful monitoring of water use and water productivity is very important. FAO is a key player in this respect since we maintain AquaStat, FAO's global information system in water and agriculture. VAPOR falls under the AquaStat umbrella, and because of AquaStat, FAO is also the custodian agency of SDG Indicator 6.4 that deals with water scarcity. But how can we monitor the performance of water use in agriculture? And how can we increase water productivity? To help answering these questions, FAO was approached by the Dutch government to set up an open access mapping system based on remote sensing to monitor in near real time the main variables to calculate water productivity. And this resulted in VAPOR. FAO did not develop VAPOR on its own. We partnered with IHE Delft, IMI, and a private-public consortium who developed the models to calculate biomass production and evapotranspiration from satellite remote sensing. The VAPOR system is unique in the sense that all data and models are open access and free to use for everybody. We are very glad that IHE Delft organized this course to help people in using VAPOR data for water productivity and water accounting studies. I wish you a lot of success. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. My name is Marloes Mul, and I'm the coordinator of the Water Accounting and Crop Water Productivity Group at IHE Delft. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the IHE Delft Open Courseware on Water Productivity and Water Accounting using WAPOR, which has been prepared in the framework of the project using remote sensing in support of solutions to reduce agriculture water productivity gaps. This is funded by the government of the Netherlands and led by the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations. The course will contain three modules, starting with introducing the WAPOR database and the different layers it contains. It also provides simple tools to access and process the data. This is followed by two modules explaining two different applications of using the WAPOR data for water productivity analysis and water accounting. Three of my colleagues will give a brief introduction on what to expect in each module. I hope you enjoy the course.
Hello everyone, my name is Bictran. I am a water accounting analyst at IHE Delft, Institute for Water Education. In this course, I will be your instructor in Module 1, Introduction and Usage of WAPOR. This module will give you information on WAPOR program, database components and usage. You will learn how to efficiently access, explore and collect the data from WAPOR web portal or WAPOR API. You will also learn how to process and analyze WAPOR spatial data using QGIS and Python programming. After completing this module, you will be equipped with the necessary knowledge and tools to efficiently use WAPOR database. You can further apply what you have learned in water productivity and water accounting studies by following Module 2 and Module 3 of the course. I hope you will learn a lot and see you in Module 1.
Hi everyone, my name is Abebe Chukala. I am a lecturer in remote sensing and water productivity at IHE Delft. My colleagues, Pulat Karimi, Sajid Paris, and I will be your instructors in Module 2 of this course. Module 2 focus on the application of WAPOR datasets for crop water productivity. In Module 2, firstly, you will be introduced to crop yield response to water, and you will learn concepts and applications of water productivity and other performance indicators, such as uniformity, adequacy, relative water deficits, and yield gaps. Then follows a step-by-step guide on how to assess these indicators using WAPOR datasets in Python scripts and QGIS. At the end of each video lecture, there will be a question or a discussion topic. I hope you will enjoy the course. See you in Module 2.
Hello, everyone. My name is Solomon Siyo. I'm a lecturer in water accounting at IHE Delft, Institute for Water Education. I will be your instructor for Module 3 of this course. In Module 3, we'll be focusing on the application of WAPOR data for water accounting. However, the methodology can be applied using equivalent remote sensing products, which are not part of VAPO. In Module 3, you will learn the concepts of water accounting and its importance for integrated water resources management. You will also learn the data requirements for water accounting and how to compare and validate remotely sensed data with in-situ measurements. On the practical aspect, you will learn how to use VAPO data for assessing water resources situation of a river basin. I hope you will enjoy the course and to see you in Module 3.